What up, boys, and welcome back to yet another gold farming video. So not too long ago, I uploaded a video where I farmed Antares on Mythic in order to get some very specific shoulder pads for leather users. And then in that video, I said that I was going to try and get the same shoulders on Heroic, because if you guys are unaware of what the farm is, I'm going to talk a bit about that first, and then I'm going to talk my plan for the raid in general. Firstly, though, I do want to say a big thank you to every single guy and girl who has picked up the 0 to 10 million gold guide. The support lately has been absolutely insane. And if you haven't grabbed it yet, just make sure you use the discount code Shadowlands and you will get it for 50% off. And the best selling point of the whole gold guide, besides from the fact that it has all of the best gold farms that I personally do in it, is the fact that it gets updated constantly. So you just got to get it once and you'll receive every single future update for free, for life. So when Dragonflight is out, I'm just going to update this very exact book with the best Dragonflight gold farms, and you guys will just receive the latest versions for free, sent to your mail. So that's going to be linked down below in the description and comment section. But pretty much whenever you do a Legion raid, there's BWE items, like epics, inside of them. And if you want to get the leather BWE items, you need to run it on a tune that uses leather. So if you want to get plate items, you need to run the raid on a tune that uses plate. So I'm targeting specifically first, to begin with, the raid Antares, which is located in Antaran Waste. And that's because there are some fancy shoulders. I showed them in the previous video. It's basically some green, red, and purple bowls on your shoulders. They're very high in demand. And the cool thing about the Legion, like epic raid items, is that you can get like four different versions of each item. And what I mean by that is, let's say you get a pair of shoulders on Mythic. They will have a specific color on them. And if you get the same exact shoulders, but the Heroic version, they will have a different color. So collectors and transmoggers, they want like one of each version, right? So there's a lot of potential here. And usually, not always, but usually, the higher you get into like difficulty, the higher the price of the item, which is why I started like running this raid on Mythic to begin with. And you guys pretty much saw my route right now. I just run in and cleared like the trash before the first boss, and then I run right back out again. And then I reset the raid and I go right back in. And that takes me roughly 1 minute to do one run. So only 10 minutes for a cap. So it's just something that I log on and do every now and then in between posting auctions to kind of deal with the auction house throttling, or just whenever I have like 10 minutes to spare. I tend to do this farm. So already did it, already got the shoulders on Mythic, which took me exactly 136 runs, which is like 2 hours of work, and the shoulders are like 600,000 gold. So yeah, as soon as they sell, I made like 300,000 gold an hour on that farm. And then I was gonna do like loot from 100 runs of like 100 heroic Antares runs, did 100 runs, didn't get anything. Did 200 runs, didn't get anything. Did 300 runs, still no items. And then at run 380 and 392, like I got two items. Sadly, it wasn't the shoulders. It was still decent items. It was these, the leggings of the Sable Stalker. Now, look at the value in my realm of these 160k. And the sell rate is at 0.03, which is really high for an item with this value. So that's like 320,000 gold in my realm, but it did take me like 400 minutes to do, or like 6.5 hours. So the gold per hour is just like, quick maths, like 50k an hour so far. But then again, it is possible to do like 400 runs and not get anything, but it's also possible to do 400 runs and get like 6 epics and make literal millions. If we take a look at the item that I'm actually after, is these bad boys, the Fellflame Inferno shoulder pad. So there's like different versions of these, different colors. You can see there's a purple one, and then you have where, there you go, you have this one. What is that, like yellow orange ish and then you have the red ones. It really just depends on what difficulty you do it on. So they're really basic, but people like basic mogs that just goes really well with like a mock transmog. I've even seen a lot of cool the rogue transmog with this on. So yeah, that was my results of 400 runs of Vantress. Now, didn't get the shoulders, which is a bummer, but I need help from you guys. Like, do you want me to keep on going and calculate exactly how many runs it's going to take me to get the shoulder pads again? Because if you guys want to see it, I'm going to do it, right? So please let me know down below in the comment section. Subscribe to the YouTube channel if this is the content that you find interesting. And of course, don't forget to check out the 0 to 10 million gold guide. And I will see you all back in at tomorrow's video. But until then, bye-bye.